Hello friends, today we are going to learn how to do running stitch. So let's begin. We are going to start on a paper. This is a colorful tinted paper. With the help of a scale and a pencil, you will draw a straight line. You can hold the paper horizontal, or if you want, you can hold the paper vertical. I prefer horizontal. I'll draw a straight line. Okay. Now I drew a straight line. The line with the pencil is very light. I have not pressed it hard. Now with the help of a scale, can you see that on one side of the scale there are numbers written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So on these numbers we'll mark a dot. These markings will help us to do the stitches. See, we've made the mark on the line. These are 1 centimeter markings. So we've got a straight line with 1 centimeter marking. We'll write alphabets for each dots. First dot is A, B, C, D. So we have named each dot. This will be useful for us to make the stitches. Now in the initial pages, we have seen how to string a thread inside the needle. This is the eye of the needle. We have stringed the woolen thread inside the eye of the needle, through the eye of the needle, and we have put a knot on one end of the thread. So let's begin the running stitch. This is point A. From behind the point, very gently you will poke your needle from the reverse side or from the behind on point A. Gently pull your string. Since this is paper, we are practicing the stitching on paper, you will be very gentle. Then on point B, see, this is point B, you will put the needle from the front side. We started from the reverse side, that is the behind, and this is the front side, and we pull the needle out. See, you got one stitch. Now again on point C, you will take it from behind. See, I'll turn the paper behind, you will see that this string has come from behind. So from here you are going to see on point C, pull the woolen thread. Again we'll put it on point D. So this is like once up, once down. Stitch one from the front side, and once you will put the needle from the reverse side of the paper. Once your thread goes behind, that's the place where you will bring the thread up from behind. So every point or every alphabet, our needle is going up and down. You can continue this for all the points till the end. This is a running stitch. So we finished our running stitch till the marking that we have made. From behind we'll tie a knot. Now I'll teach you how to tie a knot. You will pass the needle from the stitch like this, then one more time, and we've made a knot. So this is the running stitch. You have placed here. You can draw more lines and practice more running stitch.